Yeah, ninth problem. Evaluate integral over C x minus 2y dx plus y square minus x square dy. Line integral where the curve C is defined as boundary of the first quadrant of the circle x square plus y square equals to 4. This is the equation of the circle with the center 0, 0 and radius is 2. Actually r square r 4. I mean radius is 2. Now we have to integrate our function along the boundary of the first quadrant. Equation of the circle first. From this we can write equation of the circle with the center is 0, 0, radius is 2, 0, 2 square. Actually this is similar to x square plus y square equal to r square form is there. So that here r value is 2. Okay, after that we have to integrate our function along the boundary of first quadrant. Now, to integrate given function, there are different terms. If there is a single variable, we can integrate the function. So, to define single variable, the given curve name is circle. If the given equation of the curve is circle, then you should define every variable in terms of theta. This is better than Cartesian variables. So that first, choose trigonometric functions, suitable trigonometric functions. Now what are the suitable trigonometric functions for x and y? Now x equal to 2 cos theta and y equal to 2 sin theta only satisfies this equation. X equal to 2 cos theta, x equal to y equal to 2 sin theta, then this equation will be satisfied. For this, if the given curve name is a circle, in this case we have to give the preference for trigonometric functions only. As per given equation of the circle, x can be taken as r cos theta, where r equal to 2. 2 cos theta, y equals to r sin theta, where r is 2 sin theta. X defined in terms of theta, y also defined in terms of theta. Next we required dx to dy, already x y is over, dx. Now how can you obtain dx? By taking differentiation on both sides with respect to theta, d by d theta of x. Here 2 is a constant, d by d theta of cos theta. Dx by d theta equals to 2 into cos theta differentiation is minus sin theta. Same variable, this is enough. Dx equal to minus 2 sin theta into d theta. So that dyx also over. Next we need dy. From this, we can define dy. Take the differentiation on both sides with respect to theta. D by d theta of 2 sin theta. Dy by d theta equals to 2 into sin theta differentiation is cos theta. Dy equals to 2 cos theta into d theta. So that here x defined in terms of theta, y defined in terms of theta, dx also defined in terms of theta, dy also defined in terms of theta. Everything defined in terms of theta. Next we need limits also, theta limits. According to the given question, first quadrant, here theta varies from 0 to theta equal to 90. Now, theta varies from 0 to pi by 2. Now, we can integrate given function by substituting all those. Integral over C, x minus 2y, dx plus y square minus x square into dy equals integral. Here theta equal to 0 to pi by 2, x 2 cos theta minus 2 into 2 sin theta, so it is 4 sin theta into dx. Dx value is minus 2 sin theta into d theta. Next, plus. Here, what is the sign? Plus. Plus y square. I mean 4 sin square theta. Y value. Minus x value is, here x square is there. So, 4 cos square theta. Dy. Dy equals to 2 cos theta d theta. Now, integration with respect to theta, everything defined in terms of theta. Just ordinary multiplication and then integration. That equal to 0 to pi by 2. Product of these two here, this is common derivative. So that first 2 into minus 2 sin theta into first term. Minus 4 sin theta into cos theta. Here it is plus 8 sin square theta. D theta is a common variable. Next product is 2 cos theta into first term. 8 sin square theta into cos theta. Here minus 8 cos cube theta. Overall d theta is common. That equal to between each and every term there is a relation plus or minus. So that just integrate each and every term. Integral 0 to pi by 2. Before going to integrate this minus, here this is minus 4 as it is. Sin theta into cos theta is similar to sin 2 theta formula. Now here sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta cos theta. But we had only sin theta cos theta. So that sin theta into cos theta only equals to sin 2 theta by 2. Here in place of this we can write sin 2 theta by 2 plus 8 into sin square theta. We cannot integrate sin square theta. So using trigonometric formula, replace this by, we had formula, standard formula, sin square theta also expressed as 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. So that 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2 plus. Here, this is integrable formula form is there. What is that integrable formula form? Integration of f of x whole power n into f dash of x into dx. That equal to f of x whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1. As per this, we can integrate. 8 into x cos cube theta. It is not also possible to integrate directly. But we have to replace cos cube theta by using trigonometric formula cos 3 theta. Here, cos cube theta. Using cos 3 theta formula, cos 3 theta equal to 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. From this cos cube here, 1 by 4 cos 3 theta plus 3 cos theta. By writing this here, 8 into 3 cos theta plus cos 3 theta. 3 cos theta plus 3 cos 3 theta by 4. Now, integration 0 to pi by 2. Integration 0 to pi by 2. Here minus 2. Sin 2 theta plus 4 2 fourths 1 minus cos 2 theta plus 8 sin square theta cos theta 4 2s 2 into 3 cos theta plus cos 3 theta into for all d theta. Now we can integrate each and every term. Integration of first term. Minus 2 is a constant. Sin 2 t theta into d theta. 0 to pi by 2. Plus 4 is a constant. 0 to pi by 2, 1 minus cos 2 theta into d theta, plus 8 into 0 to pi by 2, sin square theta into cos theta into d theta, minus 6 is a constant, cos theta into d theta. Here minus 2 into integral cos 3 theta into d theta. Here just ordinary integration, minus 2, this is integral sin a theta. Integral sin a theta is minus cos 2 theta by 2, 0 to pi by 2, plus 4 into integration of 1 with respect to theta is theta. Cos a theta is sin a theta by a form, 0 to pi by 2, plus 8 into, this is as per this formula, f of x whole power n, f dash of x, I mean cos theta differentiation is, cos theta differentiation is here. This is out of 2, 1 has power, here also it has power. Sin theta differentiation should be beside of this. So that as per this formula, f of x whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1, out of 2 which one is the function? Sin theta, power related function. So that sin theta whole to the power of n plus 1, n plus 1 is nothing but 3 by 3, minus 6 into cos theta integration is sin theta, minus 2 into cos 3 theta integration is sin 3 theta by 3. Okay, now limits, this is limits for each and every one is 0 to pi by 2. Here minus 2 as it is, sin 2 theta integration is minus cos 2 theta by 0 to pi by 2, plus 4, integration of 1 is theta minus cos 2 theta integration is sin 2 theta by 2, after compression of this limit is 0 to pi by 2, plus 8, this is f dash of x into f of x form, as per this formula, f of x whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1, according to this formula, the third integral value can be taken as f of x, in place of f of x, what is the function here, sin theta, whole power cube by 3, minus 6 into, integral of cos is sin theta, minus 2 into, integral of cos a theta is sin a theta by a, now 0 to pi by 2. After this, here cos theta 0 to pi by 2 plus here 4 into upper limit is pi by 2 minus sin pi by 2, 2 to cancel, sin pi is there, sin pi by 2, per lower limit everyone is 0, thus the second first term is 0, second term also 0, plus 8 of 8 into, now limit for this sin 90 by sin 90 whole cube by 3, here also sin 90 whole cube by 3 minus 6 into sin 90 minus 2 sin 3 pi by 2 by 3, for lower limit every term will be 0. Now here cos pi, by writing pi by 2 in place of theta, cos pi minus cos 0 plus, here it is sin 180 is 0, only pi by 2 is there, by taking product of these two, 2 pi plus 8 into sin 90 is 1, so 1 by 3 only within box, minus 6 into sin 90 is 1, minus 2 into sin 3 pi by 2 is minus 1, so that here it is minus 2 minus 1 now by 3, by simplifying, by ordinary simplification you will get 2 pi minus 14 by 3. This is the result of given integral problem. Next given question is, evaluate integral 0 to 2 plus I z square dz. Here also you have to use line integral of complex function using the real axis to 2 and then vertically to 2 plus I. Second question given as the imaginary axis to I and then horizontally to 2 plus I. There are two sub questions to integrate given function. First, here given function, what is the given function here? Z square. Directly they define integral problem. 2 plus I z square dz. Okay, first question. Number 1. In the first question, given direction is the using the real axis to 2. I mean, first draw the line. This is x axis, y axis, real axis 2 is nothing but 2, 0. 2 and then vertically to 2 plus I. Vertically 2 plus I. 2 plus I point form is 2 plus I also written as 2, 1. This is equal to 2 plus I. Now we have to integrate this function along this line only. This is point A. This is point B. After that, here integral of 0, 0. Here point form of this one is 2, 1. Z square is nothing but x plus iy whole square. Dz is dx plus I dy. Okay, this is purely integral problem. But under integration, different variables occurred. To define single variable, we have to use given curve information only. From this diagram, we can change different variables into single variable. From this diagram, what is the point? In both the coordinates, x value is 2. Differentiate on both sides with respect to x, then dx also 0. And y only varies from 0 to 1. By writing all these here, you will get single variable function only. Integral 0 to 0, 2, 1. Here, x equals to 2. 2 plus I y whole square. Dx is 0 plus I into dy. Now, there is a only single variable function only. That is y. Out of two coordinates, we have to give the preference for y coordinates only. So that what are the y coordinates here? Y equal to 0 to 1 only. Now, this is a plus b whole square form. Now, it is also integrate directly as per x power n formula. There is a possibility here I into dy. That equal to I is a purely constant. Integral 0 to 1. 2 plus iy whole square into dy. This is x power n. Integral x power n is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. I into 2 plus iy whole cube by 3. But coefficient of y is a constant I. That constant should be in the denominator. After completion of the integration 0 to 1. Is it clear? Once again, this is similar to integral x power n formula. So, as per x power n formula, x power n plus 1 by n, but the variable coefficient is I is there. So, you should write coefficient of I in place of denominator. After completion of this limit is 0 to 1. By simplifying, I get cancelled. Upper limit in place of y. Now, 2 plus I whole cube by 3 minus lower limit in place of y. This is 2 cube by 3. That equal to just ordinary simplification. 2 plus I whole cube by 3 minus 8 by 3. That's it. Similarly, we have to integrate along the imaginary axis to I and then horizontally to 2 plus I. Similar to the first one only. Now, first draw the diagram and then make each and every one into single variable likewise, and then we can integrate with the help of limits. Okay, so first here given integration first. Well, second question, what is the given point in the second question? Here the imaginary axis to I and then horizontality to 2 plus I. Okay, according to the given point, here draw the diagram. The imaginary axis, this is imaginary axis, I also written as in point form, 0, 1. Real part is 0, imaginary part is 1. And then what is the given point, next point, horizontally. Horizontally. What is the point next, 2 plus I. Horizontally up to 2 plus I. 2 plus I, point form is 2, 1. That is, we have to integrate function along this line only. This is A, this one is B. Integration of the function 0 to 2 plus I z square into dz. That equal to 0, 0. Point form of this one is 2, 1. Z square, original value, x plus I y whole square, dz expansion is dx plus I dy. Similar to previous, here also there are different variables. We cannot integrate directly. In this case, we have to use given point. What is the given point? Integrate along this line only. From this line, we know that the x coordinate is 0 to 2. Y coordinate is same in both the points. I mean y equal to 1. Differentiate on both sides with respect to y. Dy equal to 0. And then x coordinate only varies from 0 to 2. Now here 0 to 2. Or you can write first x value as it is y I into y is 1. Dx, dy is 0. Everyone defined in terms of x. Out of 2 coordinates, here first you give the preference for x coordinates only. Why? Because everyone defined in terms of x. That equal to integral 0 to 2 x plus I into x square dx. Okay, integration of x is x square by 2. I is a constant, I is outside. Then there is a 1 under integration. Integration of 1 with respect to x is x. Limits of this 0 to 2. For upper limit it is 4 by 2 plus 2y. For lower limit everything is 0. That equal to 2 plus 2y. This is the result of second question. Now the next question also similar to previous problem. Just a function is same, point only different. Using this, we can define every different variable in single variable only. So that we have to integrate the function along this parabola only. So that first integral 0 to 1 plus I z square into dz. Integral point form is 0, 0. Point form of this one is 1, 1. Z square value is x plus I y whole square. Expansion of dz is dx plus I into dy. Here also under integration different variables occurred. To make single variable, given curve is y equal to x square. Integrate on both sides with respect to x only. Y value depend in terms of x. That's why differentiate on both sides with respect to x. D by dx of x square. Here it is dy by dx equals to 2x. By cross multiplication, dy equal to 2x into dx. Okay. Now 0, 0. 1, 1. Here x plus y into y given as x square. Next dx as it is plus I into dy, 2x into dx. The complete integrand defined only x, so that here we have to give the preference for x coordinates. In lower limit x coordinate is 0, upper limit is 1. X plus I into x square, here common function is dx. 1 plus I into 2x into dx. Here by ordinary product 0 to 1, x into first one x, 2y into x square, product with ix square, ix square into 1, I into I square, I square is minus 2x into q into dx. Now we can integrate each and every term as per integral formula. Here integration of x is x square by 2 plus 2y into x cube by 3 plus I into x cube by 3 minus 2 into x power 4 by 4. After completion of the integration, limits of 0 to 1 for upper limit. 1 by 2 plus 2i by 3 plus 1 by 3 minus 2 by 4. This is upper limit minus lower limit 0, 0, 0. Everything is 0. That equals to first real parts 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus this is 1 by 2. Plus 2i by 3. These two get cancelled. 1 by 3 plus 2i by 3. This is the result of given question.